Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous videos on UV tracking and shading with the Action Projector, you learnt all about projecting an image onto an animated 3D object and the projection tracked and distorted with the object's UVs. This applies to most 3D objects, as well as extended bicubic surfaces. So you're able to introduce texture elements onto 3D objects in the composite, and Flame automatically integrates the projection with the receiving object. This is quite powerful with pack shot work or motion graphic design. In part 3 of this series, we will complete the workflow with the Flame 2018.3 update by outputting the mat of the projection combined with UV tracking. So in this composite, we return to our pack shot example. Here we have the 3D model of the bottle that was used in part 1, and we're projecting a logo onto the bottle as an additional element for the labeling. The projected logo distorts with the 3D object through UV tracking as if it was part of the original object's texture. As long as the 3D object's UVs are correctly set up, you can achieve this on any 3D object, and your projections can also be cast on multiple 3D objects simultaneously. So you can get very creative results fairly quickly. Now, in terms of the projection, this has all been created within Action. So the 3D object is moving, which generates the UV data. And this is applied to the Action Projector, which allows for any projection to be tracked to the receiving 3D object. Now let's say you wanted to do a bit of work on the projected logo in the batch flow graph. You could obviously go back to batch and perform work on the undistorted image prior to coming into Action. However, more practically, you need to take the result of the composite in Action and tweak it further. So looking at what you see in Action, you have the result or beauty pass. To output a mat, you would switch to the output menu, and with the result viewport selected, you could either preview the mat in the render passes output selection list, or click the grey dot to enable it as an action output. Disable the action output for this video. Please note that the regular mat output is outputting the combined mat or alpha of everything in action, and not just the projection. In order to output just the mat result of the projection, scroll down the list and select Projectors Mat. This will take any projections in the composite and output their mats as a render pass. As you can see, this will also include any UV tracking and distortions generated in Action. Enable this selection as an action output by clicking on the dot next to the name. Now go back to batch. Looking at the action node, you have the main beauty render pass and the projector's mat output. Using these two outputs, you can do further effects to the projection. For example, you could color correct the logo. So go to the batch node bin and locate the color correct node. Drag it into the batch schematic. Connect the result output of action into the front of the color corrector and the projector's mat output into the mat input of the color correction node. Double-click the node for its controls and set the result up in a single viewport. Any adjustments you make from this point will only affect the projection that was created in action. Scrubbing to any frame, you can adjust your projection based on its mat. You can then combine this with other processes within the flow graph as you continue to develop and finish your composite. So that wraps up outputting a projector's mat from Action. And please be sure to check out the other workflows, features and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.